In a world, there's one man, and he's in another world. It's Uncle Snyder from Sheboygan, Wisconsin, in Swipinator 4.
We have another serious situation.
He's a man on a mission.
I'd swipe that.
Saving the world.
Schmuckadoishes.
One swipe at a time.
You swipers.
Coming to a campus near you.
This is getting serious.
It's Uncle Snyder from Sheboygan, Wisconsin, in Swipinator 4.
Thank you, Uncle Snyder from Sheboygan, Wisconsin, for the Swipinator movie. I wonder what happened to movies 1 through 3. This project is long, but I didn't want to hide anything. If you like fun details, this is the crafty fluid art painting for you. The black glossiness really sets this one apart from the rest. The weight and feel and texture is above and beyond. You might need a Bed Bath & Beyond when you're finished, but you can hang this one above the tub. Hey, seashells are waterproof. Okay, enjoy. So here we are in the garage. I'm going to make some crushed seashells look like some black crushed glass. As you can see there, it's just, there they go everywhere. So I'm just gonna lay these out here like so. Let me make sure this is on there right. Gonna get these all spread out here. And then basically just gonna take some cheap paint and spray paint it. And it won't matter that it's a matte paint, because once it gets glossed, it will be just fine. It will look glossy. Hello again. All right, I've had this canvas for a while, and I've really wanted to do something different with it. I'm going to paint it silver. The reason why, I like the silver coat. It adheres really well, and this had a lot of crazing and cracking to it. And I kind of like that about this painting that was on there that didn't work out, but basically, I know I'm going to say that again, I just like this silver look, and I'm thinking of doing some ocean rock on it. I'm not totally sure yet, but if so, I want to paint the ocean rock black, of course. And once I paint it black, it's going to be all globby, and it's kind of a thick ocean rock. And I just want it to be more globby and not so much the sand look. So just, this is a Artist Loft metallic silver. Or silver, sorry. Silver is metallic, I guess. I guess it doesn't have to be. It could just be the silver color. It doesn't have to be metallic. But this is definitely a metallic look. This is gonna look really cool. I know this part right here isn't fluid art, but we're gonna get to that. Okay, so I'm gonna let that dry really good. I went out to the garage and I painted the seashells black. It's kind of hard to do because some of them, they just didn't cover. So I'm gonna set those aside. Let's make some paint. I'm gonna do metallic bronze, metallic blue, Mars black by Basics, and metallic white. So I'm gonna go a little Floetrol on there, little on there, little on there. Oh, I should have refilled on PVA. So get some glue in there. I'm doing about half and half, half Floetrol, half glue on this one. Kind of changing my mix a little bit. Excuse you. No, excuse me. This is kind of a cool color, so I want to highlight this bronze. Oh, I forgot to mix the Floetrol stuff together first. Supposed to do that. So, if I go over that, then it just stops, and a lot of times I don't know that it stops. So that's kind of... squirted me a little bit. Metallic white. It's so weird, the light colors, I always have problems with them chunking up on me. And I'm gonna do a little test first before I pour this. Getting kind of wild with the stirring there. See how fast I can go. That's a pretty good consistency for the black. This is definitely gonna need a little more Floetrol. I probably better do a little bit of water in those colors. I do my paints a little bit heavier than others seem to do, I guess, because people have commented online. But my cells seem to stay together a little bit better too. Because if your paint's thinner, then it's gonna tilt off there faster. Still a little bit thick on that. Okay, so got that. Move those back. So I'm gonna take this up here and I'm going to tape off the edges. And I do the bottom first, just like I did on another video. I'm
The reason why I do a bottom first is you want this piece to overlap, because if the paint runs down, you don't want it running through the crack. You don't want it running through your crack. Did I just say that? Oh, sorry. All right, here. So I'm gonna leave it down. Don't put it on the curve. I'm telling you what to do again. You don't have to listen to me. This is just the way I do it. Because really, I'm learning, and I'm not really giving a tutorial, basically. I'm just showing you what I do to get these certain results. And sometimes the results really suck. So, but sometimes they turn out okay. So just make sure that the tape is on there properly. All right, so that way when it runs over, there's gonna be a nice silver line, because that's where I'm gonna put the shells on there. I'm gonna put them on the top too. So I wanna do a little bit of test here. I just wanted to see what those colors look like together. I guess they're okay. So, another thing I was going to do was tape off this. Oh man. So I'll tape it off like that. And now I'm going to add the silicone. Just two drops. One, two. I'm only adding two drops to this. Normally I add three, but there's not that much paint in there, so just mix that just a hair, just a couple of swooshes, nothing more than that. And then I'm going to lay down this bronze first, right here. Gonna get that on there nice and thick. Even let it go the edges a little bit. And then I'm going to do the black. Lay that out. Man, I almost like it with the black and the bronze. I'm gonna do just a little white on there. I'm not gonna do the blue. Here's where I don't want to swipe too much. Uncle Schneider. I want to have some difference in colors. So you saw how I did that. And I like those differences. I get just a little tiny bit on the sides. Just tap it in there sometimes. Okay, that's awesome. So I'm gonna let that dry. And then out here is where the black chunks are going to go. It's kind of like the sand pour that I did, but different. Can always come back and touch that up a little bit, but it's easier to do it right now. Let that heat up a little bit. I love that bronze color. I love the white in there too. I'm gonna get picky here and just get that on the edge there. Not playing with it too much, just a little tiny bit on the edges because I want to make sure that covers good. You see how I do this with the rag? I take a rag and I fold it and then I pull that palette knife. Instead of wiping it like this sometimes, I'll just do that number. And it's kind of cool, makes it easy. So I'm going to leave that like that. And I'll show you what it's like wet. So as you can see, it's drying here. Let me get down here. You can see the pits that's forming, and that's good. That's just like what happened on the emerald green sand pour. You can see some of the pits happening through the canvas. Again, that's good. Camera doesn't really know what to do with all the different colors going on there. It's time to peel off the tape. The reason why I want to peel it off now, even though it's still a little bit damp, as you can see, is because I don't want the paint to get too hard. Then when you go to take it off, you're going to pull off a big layer of hard paint. So it's always good to pull at a 45 degree angle. I got to do this with one hand. And you can tell there's some leakage. So we'll have to touch that up. Come on now. Here, boy. Okay, cool. Let me get down closer. So you can see all the crazing and cracking that was there before. That is also over here. I love it. It's got a lot of really cool texture to it. So when you're looking at this, you can feel it too. It makes you want to touch the painting. That's why you'll need a good sealer coat on it, because people will be wanting to touch your work. This one's actually been pretty easy so far. I hope if you try this one, it's that easy. You'll have to have a project where you let it dry really fast and craze and crack, and then just paint over it with silver. But make sure it dries for a really long time before you paint over it with the silver. Okay, so remember what I started out with? It was just crushed seashells. And I got these at Joanne's fabric store. You can get these at different places for just projects. So I went ahead and did a test of those. Remember, I spray painted them black. And see, I didn't get all sides, which is kind of what I wanted. I didn't want to get all the sides of it because some of it stays up and glitters. So anyways, I put Mod Podge on it and it's really stuck to it now. So that is what I wanted. So let's go ahead and take the project and we'll take the sides off the tape. Without ruining it, hopefully. Oh, and I let this dry for like 6 days. Just so you know. So I'm going to get some tape on here. I'm leaving it over the edge because I'm going to flip it and cut it. That's what somebody told me to do on my YouTube channel. They said, hey, try just flipping it and cutting it. So I'm going to try that. If it doesn't work, it's going to be their fault. Because I like to blame. I push blame. So they said do this number, just flip it, then cut it. Ugh, that doesn't work that great because it wants to stick to your knife. Yeah, it kind of wants to stick to your knife. Let's try it again just for the sake of it. This time I started out in the middle. There, that worked better. Much better. Okay. So now I was going to do the sides first because I want the top to kind of overlap. Okay, so I have the Mod Podge ready to go. Make sure this tapes down. So I'm going to put some Mod Podge on there. And you can find Mod Podge at lots of different stores. They even have it at Walmart, so it's not hard to find. Knew that was going to make a mess. It looks like I need to put on a thicker coat, a much thicker coat. Get a lot of it on there. Reason why. So notice this time I'm getting a lot on there. I wonder if it'll be easier just to do this number. I doubt it'll be easier, just slower. I'm gonna press those on there pretty good. So now, the last side. Isn't this awesome? Whoa, okay. Whoa, slow down there, Carl. Come back over here. Stick a little more on there. Oh, it doesn't want to stick, so that's okay. Let's get the top coat on. The reason why I'm doing it this way is because it's the way I know that works. That's why I did a tester piece first. If you all want to do a tester piece first to see how it's gonna roll, then I highly welcome you to do that. And if you want to have more of this, saved up, so you don't have to try and scrap it like me. Then that's probably a good idea. Not the easiest one I've done. The sand was a lot easier because obviously it stuck a lot better. But this is just gonna be pimp. I mean, it's gonna look tough. Rugged. Okay, so we're gonna let that dry. So I'm gonna put another coat on here and lightly drop some of these in to fill them in, and I'm not going to worry about the sides for right now, just the top. So let me go ahead and start that process. So after this is on there, I'm going to take off that tape. I'm not sure if I should drop a few more on there or not. I don't want to mess things up. I just want to make sure it's covered nice so I don't see a lot of the silver on there, you know. So I will have to go back in the garage and spray paint more of these shells. At least if I can get this top coat done, then I can worry about the sides one side at a time. So I don't even have enough to do this bottom part here. But I will let that go ahead and dry. but I want to take this tape off. Before it gets too on there. Just want to back some of those up just a hair. So I'll keep taping in different waves so I can keep showing you the process. So I'm out in the garage and I just poured the bag of seashells, crushed seashells, out on a board like I did last time. Gonna use a little cheap Walmart paint to spray them. Just like I did last time. Then I wait till that's dry. I flip them over, spray them again, flip them over, spray it again, until they're almost totally black. So, next step, wait. Okay, it's the next day, and yes, I can really see so clearly in these glasses. Oh, it's beautiful. Okay, let's get serious here. I've got me some new stuff going on here, some new shells. It took me a little while to go out and paint them black. So remember, I did the pour on top of here, but I didn't get to do this one because I ran out. So then for each side, I'm gonna need another coat too. So what I figured I would do is do another coat on one side, wait, and then do another coat, wait. So this is actually turning out to be a long, tedious process. And I might end up doing a clear sealer on this that's different than the Mod Podge. I seriously think Mod Podge ought to change their name to Mod Podge. It just sounds better. But that's my opinion. The stuff either wants to come out all at once or not come out at all. So you could tell this is pretty stuck on there. Stuck on you.
Stuck on you.
That's pretty cool. The only thing I don't want is really super sharp edges like that one right there. So I'll just kind of break those off. So let me try that. Get out of there. So even though the Mod Podge is on there, I could still come back with that sealer coat. I just want it to be nice and glossy. Super glossy. But I don't want it to have the whiteness in there. And sometimes if you put the Mod Podge on too heavy, you'll get a whiteness going on in there. All right, so now back to dry time. Okay, I'm back and it's a different day. I let this dry really good on the top part here. As you can see, it looks really cool. What I want to do is kind of shake this and tap it and let every one of those loose ones fall off. But be careful, don't cut your hand because this is kind of sharp. Some of these I want to fall off. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to tape these sections that I don't want to be hit with the glaze that I'm going to put on it, the sealer coat. Come on. This is just a safety measure here. I hope this has given you some creative ideas, even if not to do this one per se, but maybe a different one. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is the side, each side, and then I'm gonna let that dry, and I'm not going to put Mod Podge on the top here. I just want to do a light sealer to give it a real nice gloss, but not the super heavy gloss, and that way it will hold it all together too. So let's try and do a side here. And I'm going to try not to put on as much Mod Podge, just in the spots where I need it. Because I'm running kind of low on my, I went out and got more shells done. I made some more up, but I'm still running a little bit low, and that's all the shells I have, so. It might be easier to have these shells in a box where you can dip it in instead of doing this over the top. But again, this is my first time doing this, so you might find some easier ways. So you can see how much I have left in there, and it's not very much at all. So I'm going to continue to do each side, and Then we'll go out to the garage or outside to do the top sealer coat. Here we are out in the garage, and I'm going to put a coat of Rust-Oleum 2x Ultra Cover Gloss Clear on it. So let's see what this is going to look like. Oh, that's pretty. Make sure I get it all. Oh, that's going to shine. Yeah. All right, so I'm going to let that dry and then put another coat on. So here's the finished product on this one. I finally finished it. Woohoo! I know it still looks wet and all that, but it is not. I wanted to make sure I got those things plastered on there. That way they weren't falling off. I still have a few that do fall off, but I think that's kind of normal for this type of project. I hope you guys like it. I hope you can try it. I know it's a little more difficult of a project, but I hope you can try it or something like it. I hope this gave you an idea for some other projects you've been wanting to try. Okay, she's hanging on the wall and I'm loving it. Thanks for watching. You are awesome. And I hope this inspired you. Here's how many edits were in this video. This project took 9 days, 5 hours, and 57 minutes to complete. Still going. Still going. And the end. Yay!
Something is coming from my office. Oh, it's just you. What in tarnations are you still doing here? Shoot, man, you need to go home. Catch some shut-eye. Go on now.